Don't you spit big on fan. It too?
Oh, good question.
Every
you
time.
You spit on it?
Does she? Well, I'm asking, do you? I think you do.
You spit.
If you have a bowel movement and things are not what you want them to be to clean up, and you don't have flushable wipes, or you don't have water handy.
It's like make your own wipe.
Spit. So normally you don't. Your saliva is slippery, and so.
So normally you don't.
It's not an every time.
I have to admit, actually, most of the time I do.
That's awesome.
Okay.
Welcome back to Privy. Privy is a podcast about bathrooms, recorded from my home bathroom. And this is kind of a podcast first, because I am joined by two folks this week, and in my home restroom. Anna's the only guest who's been in the home restroom so far. So this is kind of a treat. I have Michael and Kimberly Wall. How are you guys?
Hello, doing great.
Perfect.
Hi, I am well. Thank you.
Awesome. I know you guys, I would say a medium amount. Pretty good. But I know your children, so it counts. But who are you? And people have already heard from Michael, so you can just shed it if you want. But who are you? How are you guys connected? What's your relation? Feel free. Either of you, go ahead and talk over each other. Do whatever you need.
Well, we've been married. August 7th will be 30 years.
You're married.
Married, yeah.
Perfect. 27, you said?
30.
37.
30 total.
Whoa.
1993, August 7th.
That's awesome. That's coming up, too.
Yes.
Kind of amazing.
That's super cool. Wow. Yes.
And we have two children, adult children, David and Bethany.
Yes.
We can get into this later, but they're adults. They're in their 20s and on their own.
We are empty nesters.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we are.
Do you enjoy that, or is it still kind of weird?
I've gotten used to it now.
For the most part, we enjoy it. They've been out of the house for a while.
Yeah. I don't know. I know, like, when I left, my parents were like, this is weird. And then they moved over here. your kids kind of went different directions.
Yeah, ours are far away.
They're both out of state, so.
Yeah.
And it's been a while, so I've gotten used to it.
That's hard for mom.
Yeah. Yeah. How about dad?
It was difficult.
Yeah, that's fine. It's good.
Yeah, well.
It's probably better that it's difficult than not, because.
It was difficult. And then, of course, Bethany got married, and that was last September.
Yep.
So that's almost a year.
Yeah.
No grandchildren on the way yet, so far as we know.
Perfect. Hey,
we would love to have grandchildren.
Yeah, absolutely. David's still got some extra steps to go through, huh?
Right on.
Yes.
but he's doing well.
Good.
He's growing.
Yeah. Is he, is he still in, is it Phoenix?
Where is he at? Mesa.
Mesa. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Greater Phoenix area.
Wow.
And doing well.
Wow. Interesting. Does he see the Grand Canyon, or is it just kind of like, it's there and it's close, so I don't need to go to it? Have you asked him? You should ask him.
He went that direction. I'm not sure if he saw the Grand, but he saw something because he went that direction.
Yeah. Because I grew up in Montana and Glacier Park, or not Glacier, Yellowstone. I've never been to Yellowstone.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, because it was there, and I said, I can go anytime I want.
And I never did.
Never been.
Time to take your family, then.
Yeah, now you can take your family.
There you go.
Have memories.
Oh, that actually, the kids would love that.
Yes.
So, Michael, you've been a custodian for countless years. You could probably count them, but you don't have to if you don't want.
Yeah, my mind went blank.
24 plus BBC as well.
What is this?
24 or 25?
Well, I started in December of 1998 with the school district.
Yeah. But he was a custodian at BBC.
That's right. It'll be 25 years with the school district this December.
And one of the elementary schools there in the Boise area.
Really?
Yeah, I did custodial work for a job when I was at BBC for a short time.
At BBC or
at BBC?
Really?
Mm-hmm. And then I did subbing in the school, probably Boise School District. Mm-hmm. I did some subbing for a few months.
Wow. Huh. So, but Kimberly, you've also kind of, I don't know, you've done custodial work both with Michael. Have you done it separate from him?
No, just helping him.
Just with him. Okay.
The last 2 months.
Especially helping him.
It's been longer than broken just 2 months. Yeah, yes. Michael, so you've got a broken shoulder. Do you want to share a little bit about, I see you rubbing it. Do you need medicine?
No.
I've got stuff in that cupboard. They prescribed me some good stuff for upcoming things. So.
Pill or cream?
Pill. I could probably find cream.
So it was May 5th. Cinco de Mayo. I was heading home from work about 11:30, and I had that accident. Just a single bike.
From being a custodian.
Single bike accident on my way home from work. No car, no other bicycle, no other car, no car. And I went over on my left side, and I fractured my left upper arm.
Yeah.
So.
Ouch.
Next Monday, July 10th, I returned to work to the school district.
There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. It's.
You've been 2 months out then?
Almost 2 months.
Wow.
Almost 8 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah. It's gotten better. But I understand it'll take, could be 4 to 6 months before you get the total.
Right.
You know, like the before the accident feeling back. So.
Yeah. He needs greater mobility still.
Yeah. Yeah.
And strength. It'll take time to strengthen it.
Yeah. Has he milked it at all, Kimberly? A little bit?
I guess I'm not sure. He's actually helped me out quite a bit.
Cool.
Doing things that I thought he should not be doing.
Oh, this past, in June I was helping you.
Yeah.
Yeah, in May it was total, I mean, and maybe I did like an hour total worth of work for the church. And she took over in May and June.
Yeah.
So I'm back to the church though now. I've been, in June I was doing a lot of some work too.
He could still vacuum and clean toilets, but I needed to do the mopping
or any
heavy lifting of garbage.
Not anymore.
Huh. Yeah.
I just have limited mobility.
Yeah. Stretching it.
Yeah, I got to stretch it.
He needs to let his wife help him stretch it.
So he was a custodian when y'all met? Or was it shortly after?
No.
It was after.
After. He was a Burger King worker and
that was my first
Bible college student.
Yeah.
That's why you love Burger King.
And singing on
City
the image
there.
Of Christ.
Huh.
The year we met, I was on the image of Christ. And then I came back.
Wow.
And then in August, we got married.
So you guys met in Bible school? No.
He was in Bible school. I was best friends with his younger sister, Kathy.
We met at my parents' house in Goldendale.
Got it.
Huh. Yeah.
December of 91.
Wow.
Correct?
I thought you met at Bible school.
Well, I was going to Bible college.
Yeah, it's different.
But not in it.
Huh. I didn't go to school to get my MRS degree.
Yeah, there you go. You saved money on it, which is wise.
I helped put hubby through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, and then he did youth ministry, which I won't let him forget.
Correct.
Yeah. He tells me every time Ben leaves, he goes, "Well, you're up." And I said, "You realize if I take vacation, I'm not canceling youth and you're up then. That's how this works."
That's good.
Not really. Well, very cool.
He could do it probably.
Yes, he absolutely could. So Kimberly, people already have heard from Michael, but and feel free to make as much noise with that as you can, because it's part of the whole thing. Perfect. It really is. I do it every episode now. What is it that you want to share with folks as far as who you are, background to give people a picture of you?
Well, I'm very much a small town girl, so coming to Albany, living in Albany, has been challenging, to say the least.
Yeah.
Sometimes I say that I feel like a caged cat, and I need to get away to the mountains.
Yeah, yeah. You're from Kooski?
No, I'm actually from a little town east of Kooski called Elk City.
Elk City, okay.
Yes. Tucked away in the mountains.
Yeah, because Anna and I got marooned in Kooski, And it was one of those weird, I'm from that area. I'm like, who is possibly from here?
Michael calls me a hick from the sticks. So I'm proud to wear that name, though. I don't mind.
Michael, you need to head out to Montana and just go see where I went to high school. The town I grew up in has like 6 bars and a chicken joint and a gas station.
What town was that?
Sun Prairie.
Oh.
It's a...
We toured Montana with the Image of Christ.
Nobody tours Sun Prairie.
We didn't even go through... Doesn't even ring a bell.
There's not a living soul on this planet that tours Sun Prairie. It's a housing... It doesn't even have a post office. They won't give it a post office. Wow. It is a housing settlement, not a development, a settlement of Great Falls, which is where all the ice... It used to be where all the military people and old people like retired to and went to for military. Anyway, so I get the small town thing.
All but where did you go to high school? Sims?
Sims, yep.
And I've driven through Sims.
Yep, Sims is out there. It's got a fire station and a church that used to be a bar and like a post office.
Yeah, well, little town of Elk City.
Yeah.
Has, Elk City was probably larger.
3 bars.
Yeah.
Used to have a sawmill, and I worked at the sawmill.
Oh, cool.
And
it's still larger. Probably has
2 churches.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Sims had a church. At least one. I think it had 2. I think it had a Bible and a Catholic church.
Well,
it's interesting
we had
that
a,
you separate those.
Yeah, but. A Baptist church, and then there was a Catholic priest that came in, but a community church.
Interesting.
And they would meet in the community church. Huh. Yes.
Interesting. Elk City.
Elk City, Idaho.
Yeah.
And there's a song that was written about it.
Really? Like, by who?
I don't know the artist's name off the top of my head.
Oh,
I
we'll
can find
to,
it for you.
We'll have to, I'll search that up. it'll be good.
The first line goes, there's a little bitty town at the end of the line of Idaho 14.
Yeah. Huh. I hit a giant rock. Out there. So it is way out. Well, very cool. And so y'all met, you're married, and now you have been living together and loving every minute of it, especially the parts related to where we are sitting now, which we're going to get into. But Kimberly, so we've already heard these from Michael. I have a few questions. I'm going to ask you them, some of them quickly, and I'm sure that Michael will chime in here because I'm sure he's got some opinions on your thoughts. That happens a lot.
I'll just laugh.
Yeah. But you already noted, we were talking before, but my toilet paper right now is over, and you said you're an over...
Rolling off over the top.
Mm-hmm. And why...
We agree.
You guys... Okay, noted, Michael. Why is that? Why?
It's easier to grab.
Okay.
You don't scratch the wall with your fingernails.
Scratching the wall.
You're literally 4 inches from the... If you started with a full roll, it's like 4 inches from the wall.
All right.
Yeah.
Just, you know, Charmin sells a... They don't even sell it. It's free. Just pay shipping. But it's a roll extender. Now, I haven't...
So it sticks out further?
Yeah, it kicks it out another inch or so.
Because you can get a jumbo roll.
Yeah, you can get a big roll on it. Yeah.
Well, and Charmin's rolls are thick and large.
I noticed when you first start some of those jumbo rolls, they rub the bathroom wall, literally. Until you roll it enough.
I almost always unroll it about 10 things before I even stick it on here.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, if you can't stick your hand behind it. Anyway.
Cool.
So you're over. Toilet paper. Do you, and feel free to be like, you know what? Nah. But your process, do you fold it, crumple it? What's the process?
When my children were little, we read a book about that. The different ways people do it.
There's a book?
Children's book about going to the bathroom and bathroom etiquette and how you take care of the paper in order to clean yourself.
Yeah. You're not alone as a parent.
You have helps.
You have helps.
Yeah.
It's your books.
So I'll just share that I fold it.
Yeah. It's the sign of an organized mind.
Don't you spit on
fan.
It too?
Oh, good question.
Every
you
time.
Spit on it?
I'm asking, do you? I think you do.
You spit?
If you have a bowel movement and things are not what you want them to be to clean up.
Oh.
And you don't have flushable wipes.
Yeah.
Or you don't have water handy.
It's like make your own wipe. Oh.
Spit. So you don't. Your saliva is slippery. Oh. And so
normally you don't.
It's not an every time
I have
thing.
To admit, actually, most of the time I do.
That's awesome.
Okay.
My mama invented that.
Awesome.
Her mama taught her that or something.
That's what I thought.
Spitting on the toilet paper.
Cleans you up way better than water.
That is amazing.
That's a new question. Do you spit or not?
Yeah. Have you ever spit on your toilet paper to fashion your own
I bet most people. Wipe? There's some that do, but I bet most don't.
I'm confident.
You know, unless you're in camping or something.
So, Michael, I've asked almost 25 different people these questions now. This is the first time I've heard anything about spit involved. Never has there been spit involved. I have one guy who's like, I'm a flushable wipes man. Except for he doesn't flush them.
Because they're not
why.
Flushable.
They're not, but he, so I'm like, so your trash had just got.
Yeah, like third world country.
Whew. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. But it's just in restaurants, he pulls out his flushable wipes from his bag.
There you go.
Yeah. I'm like, that's wild.
There are trash bins right there next to the privy for a reason.
I mean, so this is the thing is guys don't have that. And so he carries the ball of like poo wipe to the trash by the paper towel.
Oh.
Which is,
you must wrap it up really well.
Here we are. That's why I was fascinated with this thing.
I'm glad I can educate you.
Yeah, this is. I'm not gonna lie. I am gonna try it. I will be trying it. Kimberly, do you use bar soap or liquid soap?
Both.
Both. Is it like, depending on is it? Because I know a lot of people are like liquid soap has to go for hair. That's what that's all about. Is that
no
kind
shampoo
of,
and conditioner for
okay.
hair?
So yeah. You're just. It's just
liquid soap if you want to use
you mean like body wash?
You know, the
yeah.
The what do you call it? The
washcloth? Loofah?
Loofah no. thing loofah. Or the yeah.
The big puffy thing.
The big puffy
with the string on it.
Netted wash, you know, that you would use a body wash with.
We use washcloths. They're kind of like that. It's like a small towel.
I use washcloths as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, that's
I also use
for.
A hand mitt. So hand a bar mitt. Or liquid
oh, yeah.
soap works great for a hand mitt.
Mm. It's kind of yeah. small, doesn't fit my hand too well.
That's kind of like, I feel like I've seen people use those for like a car, like washing a car.
Yeah.
Similar. But these are exfoliating hand mitts. Yeah, so
feels good.
Scrubs
never,
away
I've
the
never
dead
heard of that
skin.
For a shower.
Feels good when you have your spouse rubbing your back.
Oh, yeah? How often does that happen? You did it, not me. I didn't ask. You said it.
Not too often.
Yeah.
Whenever but like how often? We decide.
Once
there
a month.
You go. Sheesh. Once a month. There you go.
Whenever we decide.
There you go. Hey, you got a license for it, so
that's
what
right.
am I to say?
That's right.
Kimberly, what's your opinion on baths? Do you like baths?
I love to take a good, refreshing, cleansing, soaking bath.
Yeah. So.
Yep.
Do you like baths? I can't remember.
No. Yeah. No. I mean, I don't. No.
See, so.
Just shower.
This is why I am excited for you to be here. Because so far, Anna's only been another lady. And she's a big fan of baths. And most guys I talk to are like, I don't know about baths. You know.
They need a shower after you soak in the bath?
And I know that, I don't know if it is this, but I know that it's. I know there's more women that are going to be willing to say, I love baths. I love taking baths. Mm-hmm. And so.
Calgon, take me away.
What?
Calgon, take me away.
Calgon, take me away.
I don't even know if they make it anymore. It's called Calgon. It's a bath soap. You know, that it and it's bath soap or whatever they call that stuff.
Calgon.
And what it was mean? Called Calgon. And the old, probably 80s.
Calcium gone? Is that
no,
what it's
Calgon.
Short for?
No, Calgon. And this is an 80s commercial, and the commercial goes like, the dog, the kids, and then the ladies, Calgon, take me away. And the next
scene
is a woman's in a bathtub covered with, you know.
Excuse me?
She's in a bathtub. It's got suds.
On national television?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was Calgon, the bath ladies, it was more feminine, bath soap.
Interesting.
Was it like a fizzing bath bomb?
It could have been.
Was it a...
I don't know. I never used it.
A body bar?
But was I used to make fun of the commercial. I used to say
a bubble
like...
bath?
I used to say like, the dog, the kids, the husband, Calgon, take me away. Or the in-laws, Calgon, take me away.
It's careful. Like,
anybody from the 80s, yeah. Maybe into the 90s, 80s. But the 80s.
So
he didn't have in-laws
I don't even know if
that
they
time.
Sell it anymore.
Yeah. When Chris Luckman was on the show, he told me about a deodorant named Sure. Are
sure.
you aware of this?
Yes.
Really?
Uh-huh.
I had never heard of this.
Sure. And again, the commercials.
Yeah, raise your hand if you're sure.
Yeah,
that's
raise
what
your
he
hand.
Told
raise
me.
Your hand. Raise your hand if you're sure.
Yeah.
And everybody would raise their hands.
Yeah. He told
again,
me
the
that,
80s.
And I thought he was messing with me.
Again, I don't think they sell it anymore.
So no, they don't. I've looked. Yeah.
Another unique thing about me is I grew up with no television, so yeah. I do not know all the commercials and all the
Elk
jingles
right.
to the commercials.
Elk City is
people
your
in Elk
why.
City have televisions. My family chose not to.
You're better off for it.
You can get cable up there, too.
You're better off for it.
We didn't want to be sitting around wasting our time, I guess. That was my dad's
but, you know,
reason.
I'm guilty of my kids have screens, but man... We go out of our way to limit it.
Good.
I see, like, Anna and I get, triggered's not the right word, but we see, like, kids who are, I would say, of a significant age. I'm talking past 6, 7, 8. Mm-hmm. Like, they're in school or maybe should be schooled in some way.
Yeah.
And they're, like, sitting in restaurants and they can't not have the tablet.
Mm-hmm.
And that, to me, is, like, we've got a problem.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Danger zone.
I told the kids, I was like, listen, if y'all get to that, they're all gone. Like,
yep.
I'm going to make a quick couple $100 selling them on Facebook, and we're going to be done. Yeah.
So, baths.
Yes.
The last time I took a bath was, a few days, maybe a week after my bicycle accident. You said, take a bath, and you put Epsom salt, and I just soaked in the tub.
Yes.
Epsom salt.
Yeah. Epsom salt.
Yep.
Yep.
Encouraged him to relax
that was
muscles.
My, it was all blowing.
Start
it was
some healing.
Bloated and it was all multicolors, my shoulder
yeah.
and my arm.
Yeah. Oh. It was all purple. It was gross.
Yeah.
You were very swollen.
It was gross.
But see, that felt good and it was for a reason and for a purpose.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know.
Had to twist some arm to convince you to do it though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully not. No. Hopefully the other arm. No.
The right arm.
Yeah.
Figuratively speaking.
So in related to that, so I am big fan of showers and I spend a lot of time thinking about how I can optimize my shower experience. So Kimberly, have you ever taken a dark shower? Just shower in the dark, no lights.
I'm sure I have.
Yeah.
I can't remember the instance, but or the lights are low just because
yeah.
I'm sleepy. I just want to
yep.
shower and
that's
get
it.
To bed.
Yeah, I'm
so
a big
I probably
fan.
Have, but
yeah, I almost every time is dark, and there's no mm-hmm. you can see there's no windows in here, so it's
oh it's dark
really
yeah,
dark.
That night light's essentially what supplies the light
oh,
during a dark shower.
Dark.
You can still,
I think we have about a 2x3 window in our bathroom,
yeah,
so
yeah.
quite large, so it can let in
yeah,
porch light.
Yeah, our old place had that, and it was nice. Mm-hmm. You didn't have to turn the lights on if you needed mm-hmm. them, but. The dark shower was not super dark usually, mm-hmm. unless you
mm-hmm.
did it at night. Yep. Have you ever eaten an orange in the shower as if it was an apple? Now, this is I ask this because
no.
it's a thing people do. They peel the orange, and then instead of eating like plugs of the orange, they just apple bite the whole. Like,
so your juice
glow.
Is dripping
yep.
in the
yeah.
shower with you.
Yep, it's a thing. It's a thing people do. I don't know why. I've done it a couple times.
I never
having
have.
Tested it, and it was fine. I was less worried about mess. As a person,
well, there
a,
you go.
As a person with a beard, it was nice because you didn't have to like worry about that. But
just washes away.
Yeah. Do you ever enjoy? Yeah. Do you ever enjoy anything like snacks in the shower, snacks or drinks?
I enjoy listening to podcasts in the shower.
Oh, really? Okay.
Or listening to Bible in the
yep.
shower.
Yep.
Listening to music in the shower.
Yeah. But no food or drink?
No, not typically.
No.
Yeah. No snacks.
I might bring it into the bathroom and eat it if I'm in a rush and perfect. I have to go to the bathroom.
Yes.
eating on the go.
So that is a thing you do.
Occasionally, yes.
Perfect.
Out of necessity.
So it's not like I need to use the restroom and grab a snack on the way. It's
no.
I don't. Okay. Because there's that. I'm of that persuasion. There's some foods that are better on the toilet.
Well. There are certain instances when I don't want Michael to eat my snack.
Yes.
So I take it in the bathroom with me.
Yeah.
Oh, and he'll, I know
Michael. If I leave it behind, it'll be gone when I come out.
He has no stop on that.
Seafood, eat it.
Yep, he's into everybody's snacks all the time. you hear this? She takes her snack to the bathroom. So just leave her alone. Let her have her snack.
Good one. Thank Michael, you, Hunter.
Michael, jeepers. She's holed away in the bathroom.
Somehow we're still married. I'm not sure how that can be.
Hey, 37 years is...
30.
I said 30 this time. 37. You heard what you wanted to hear, Michael. Is it not 37?
30.
Oh, this is fun. You guys are both going to get this too because it's the one call now for the week. It's going to come through. I'll listen to the voicemail later.
30 years.
I thought you said 37.
No, 1993. 2023 will be
30. August 7th. Oh, so 30 even. Yeah,
30.
30.
That's still 30. A lot.
Mm-hmm.
Sheesh.
It is. How'd we make one it month this to far? Go. Yeah. Only by the grace of God.
Wow. Yeah. Yeah.
His help.
Yeah. Especially if you're eating snacks in the bathroom because Michael will leave alone. Kimberly, have you ever performed a waffle stomp? I asked the question looking at Michael. Do you know what a waffle stomp is?
I guess I do not know what that is. I know what those shoes were called, or a certain boot was called a waffle stomper back when I was
back in the 70s.
It had like a Vibram sole to it, and it would track mud and dirt and barnyard debris.
So
they were hiking boots.
Yes. So similar idea. But it's essentially you just poop into the bottom of the shower and then you stomp it down.
No, thank you.
So that's a no.
Probably a lot of these questions are no.
That's fine.
That's acceptable.
Which do you think is more acceptable? To perform that deed or to try and I don't know who these people are. Because this is...
Retrieve it and put it in the toilet?
Yep.
She guessed you.
Yeah. Whoa. That's a thing that people do. Instead of just like... Mm-hmm.
In an emergency situation, I would do what I needed to do. But yeah, that would not be pleasant.
Yeah.
I would want gloves on my hands.
You'd jump out, right?
Yeah. If you have to go, you get out and go. That's
Yes.
I'm persuaded that's the way to do it.
If I have that kind of control, I suppose there are times bodily function.
I think this will be entertaining. So the last stomp that I performed was at the church.
Gross.
In the shower.
In the shower.
And then I'm cleaning up after you.
No, I cleaned it.
Oh, thank you. I ensured
that it was clean. But yeah, that's the most recent stomp for me. We don't need to... I'll say it's 2023, though.
Yeah, because...
Oh, he was just before his accident.
Yeah.
Oh, so I didn't clean that.
Yeah. I wouldn't have done it if I would have known that you would have been cleaning. But I did clean it. You didn't even know. That's how you know I cleaned it.
Yeah.
Well, I know for little children, like sometimes confession. That warm bath water makes them have to go.
Oh, mm-hmm. and some of them float, which is always an exploration. The ones that don't float are the troubling ones because then they're like in bath.
Mm.
And you got to do the full reset.
So here's what I know from working at the YMCA as a lifeguard.
Yes.
If there's any feces in the water, they have to shut the pool down. And I think it's about 17 hours.
Whoa.
It's a minimum of 12. I'm not remembering the exact number. Wow. Just because of the possibility of bacterial infections.
What's that called? It's called like cryptosporidium. It like, you get bad sick, but it's from pooping pools.
Yeah. So you have to do a huge chlorine shot.
Whoa. Does the pool actually change color when people pee, or is that like a TV thing?
I guess I don't know, honestly. Because, like,
you, in the movies, whenever anybody pees
the water
pool,
gets warmer.
It's like a big cloud of blue around them. It's like blue and green has spread from them.
Yeah,
that must
I'm not
be a myth.
Sure.
That
I'm
must
not
be
sure.
a myth. It has to
I'm
be.
I'm sure it happens a lot, so I think you would
yeah.
You would say, oh, somebody there, yeah, oh, you, somebody there.
I think if that was real, you wouldn't ever go to a pool because you'd just be little pockets.
That's the purpose of chlorine.
Fluorescent, yeah. Oh, man, yeah. So we did bathroom snacks. I want to make sure I get all the old ones. Cool. So it's a special set of questions.
Just for me?
Yeah, just for the two of you. These are duo questions. You guys are the first duo. I've got a number of these that I'm going to try of various relations between them. I've got one that's old roommates and that one's going to be a treasure, but, so what is the strangest thing, Kimberly, that Michael does in the bathroom, in your opinion, that you know of?
Well, I would personally say just using reams and reams of toilet paper and plugging the toilet up because I think he's afraid to get anything on his hands. So if he comes to your home and he has to have a bowel movement and you checked and your toilet paper roll was full and then it's only half full, you know who was in your bathroom.
Yeah, either you or my daughter because she will just...
Okay, I thought... Well, I don't plug it. I mean, it happens, but it doesn't happen often. But I thought you were going to say when I wipe my bottom.
Confessions.
And actually, when I wipe my bottom, okay. I'm not the bottom's not always over the toilet bowl.
That's
and
true.
And then I get those little, what do you call?
Well.
What do you mean your bottom's not over the toilet bowl?
Well, because you move. Yeah, you want to move around. You don't.
No.
Yeah.
You don't. You kind
of. No, because then he gets the toilet paper, dirty, soiled toilet paper debris.
Yeah, little pieces
on the floor
of it,
and on the rug.
Up. Very tiny, teeny tiny, minute pieces
I don't know
on
where
the rug or on the floor.
Yeah.
Are you
I'm not sure.
I thought you were going
to
say that.
Are you standing up to wipe?
Not. Semi. Well, not standing totally erect, but you know, you move around. And it feels good to move around, and you wipe in different positions.
It feels good to move around.
And this is new.
Maybe,
I didn't share this
you don't
last
have,
time.
You,
maybe
yeah, you
it's
didn't.
Because of his broken arm. That
so
he
I thought you were
going to
say that.
Yeah.
But about the little pieces of shreds.
No, it's more because remember, I grew up in a very pragmatic or practical, frugal family. So
yes.
You only used what was absolutely necessary.
Yep.
So you go very lightweight on the toilet paper, if at all possible.
Yeah, my dad was in the military, and it was like, listen, you don't need 5 sheets. If you can't do it in 3 to 4, then you need to eat more cheese. That's
and,
what I would say.
And fingers will wash.
Yes.
Should happenstance.
Just today I had to wash my hands because I got...
You pole punched yourself?
Yeah.
Yep, there it is. So Anna and I talked about, so there's these girls, and boys, but like these girls, these women that have these fingernails that
ouch.
Are like an inch long. Oh, you're good. It's the one call now.
Is it east side? Just let go to, let's go, that's east side.
And I just.
Goldie.
It'll go
you have it under Goldie. It should be under east side.
Mine rings all mine sorts of people.
Under Goldie.
But how do they wipe?
So
they have these talons, and I regularly accidentally get through the paper. I don't get it.
I don't know how you wipe
maybe
with long fingernails.
Maybe they do the snowball.
Oh, crumple
toilet
it.
Paper.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's true. Maybe that. Oh, I'm just gonna assume anybody who has fingernails that are long.
Doesn't your
crumbles.
Wife have longer fingernails?
No, her. No, hers are mostly just painted.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Not long though.
She's had the like nails put on once, and she hated it.
You can't do anything safe in them.
She worked retail at Jockey, and they wanted them
safely.
To have nice nails.
Mm-hmm.
And so she did it once, but she's like, this ain't it. Which I will say, I'm so thankful that she's like, she's practical when it comes to that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The nail polish things she buys, they...
It's just a stick-on.
Yeah, and you don't have to have the giant bag. This is the thing for me is storage is a little zipper case.
Nice.
It's not the big tray of polishes. I'm like, I can get on board. So, Michael, then same question here. This could be, and I will also say, if he says anything that you're like, yeah, I don't want that out there, Editing's great. Michael, what's the strangest thing that Kimberly does in the bathroom, in your opinion?
I don't really know, but the length of time she spends.
Well, I mean, everybody's different.
20 minutes going number two.
I think...
Half hour.
Yeah. I think it's a lady thing. I really do. Because Anna's an extended stay as well.
Yeah. So if I were to walk in right after she walks out, nothing. Everything looks good.
Yeah.
So
I'm pretty much a neat Nick.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
So I don't... it's just the length of time.
Yeah. Well, that's easy enough.
We only have one bathroom. So if he really has to go to the bathroom,
he's got a yard.
I'm going to the bathroom.
He's got a yard.
I got a backyard.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he doesn't take a shovel out there.
No, I'm not talking number two, just number one.
Well, you could do it.
He could have.
So, no, there's nothing.
You get yourself a 5-gallon bucket and just sit on it and go. It's fine.
I did that for many, many years as a child.
Yeah. Michael, ew.
In Elk City.
A bucket in the house because it was deep snow, freezing temperatures, and the outhouse was a walk away.
And the outhouse was your
only bathroom.
Whoa.
for several years. Yeah.
You're in the sticks.
Other people had running water, but at that time we did not have
running
water.
This is the 70s, right?
It was
That might have been part of it too. Because I was going to say, like, to my knowledge, everybody had running water where I was from.
Yeah.
So that's way out
there. We had drilled a well, and we only were able to get 2 gallon a minute, and it had lots of mica schist dust in it.
Mica schist.
So Dad did not develop that for our running water to the house because he would have to be changing out filter systems constantly. So we had water that we would pump in a hose to huge 50-gallon garbage cans. So in the wintertime especially, or early morning, late night, we had a 5-gallon bucket with a lid on it, and that was our toilet for those hours.
She could survive longer in the wild than you or I combined. You know that, right?
I've got some skills.
I'm fine with saying it.
I've got some skills.
I'd be dead in a week. Kimberly would have shelter in a tree.
I'm not sure. I'd figure something out, though.
Yeah. If push came to shove, I could survive.
He wouldn't know how. He'd need his wife to help him know how.
Michael, you have different positions for wiping. Anyway, who has more soaps in the shower or bath? Who has more soaps?
Me.
Yeah?
Of course. Yeah.
Okay. Because there's some people are like, no way. He has more soap, so you're just owning it.
There's 11 bottles in the...
Holy cow.
And they all belong to her. Three are like plain bottles.
You gotta use something.
That don't have what they say is in them. And the other like eight...
Oh, that's right. You have the bottles that don't have the right stuff
in it. Yeah, three of them are like that. And then eight of them are actually what they say they are. But I just grab... There's one bottle I use of shampoo that I use.
What's in the...
One is labeled vinegar because I use that as a hair rinse sometimes, especially with chlorine in my hair from the swimming pool.
Yeah.
So I rinse the chlorine out. One of them is just Dr. Bronner's soap that I'll use it like a liquid bath soap.
Dr. Bronner's.
Yes. There's a peppermint that's very refreshing and smells lovely.
Is that a brand?
Dr. Bronner's is a brand. You can get it by Mart and Walmart. It's just a pure Castile soap with some essential oils added in.
Interesting.
Yeah, so it's natural.
Huh.
When Bethany lived with us, there were 19 bottles, and maybe three or four were not what they said they were, and the other 16.
Drove him crazy.
But 19 bottles. And those were just between Bethany and Kimberly.
Because
you don't use any of them.
Michael, just one.
You use one.
Yeah.
When he has hair. He didn't have hair.
Well, I didn't have hair then. I shaved my head for years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So all he needed was a bar of soap to just lather up with.
Yeah, just run the bar all over your body.
Yeah.
Including your bald head.
Huh. It's a lot of bottles, 19.
So, in that respect, I can get along fine with nothing.
Right.
I don't need
11
bottles.
No, you should use soap. You should.
Having that broken arm prove that there's some bacteria that gets underneath there.
Who cleans the toilets at home?
She does. Usually me.
Really?
Not always. He has.
Is that because you clean them so often, like at the school and stuff? Or is it just church. Like how it...
Well, she cleans the bathroom.
Division of labor, I guess.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
I do a lot of washing of dishes. She does the bathroom.
Yeah.
And sometimes he rewashes dishes. I'm just a little more thorough. I take a little more time. And
yeah.
So.
There's... Yeah, everybody... has the system. And
in between the times when she deep cleans the bathrooms, though, you notice there's your toilet, I don't know what you call it, mold or not mold, but whatever grows on the in the toilet bowl.
Oh, yeah, the bowl, the ring.
Yeah, or the ring black, and other stuff. Ring. So I just take some TP and wipe that up so then it looks white again. And then I flush
it. I'm confident that that's like our water has...
Yeah, it could be the water.
I think some is a little bit of
it sits just there
residue and it grows some bacteria or mold. Yeah.
That
and I do the same. Sometimes I'll, you know, if a gentleman lifts the seat to urinate, then that gets debris on it, so I'll wipe up that debris.
Well, apparently Michael gets debris when he does the number two job as well. So
it's all
You better be hitting the bowl, Michael. Come on. Come on. Okay, so I'm going to ask Kimberly first. Who takes the longer shower?
It depends. Sometimes we're about even.
Really? Is that...
It depends on if Michael wants a hot, long, cleansing, meditating shower. Or listening
shower
to music.
Shower thought shower.
Yeah.
Yeah, now that I have a beard and a head with some hair on it.
It has hair.
I take a longer shower. But when I was shaving my whole head, if I shaved in the shower, I would take a while. So that's the other thing. Yeah. If I didn't shave in the shower, I wouldn't take very long. But shaving in the shower, your head and face and everything, took a while.
Those porpoise showers, like to get smooth like a porpoise, it takes some time.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, that's fair. All right.
Well, and for gals, if I shave in the shower, that takes me a little longer.
Yeah, that's...
If I'm just washing...
It's probably even.
Yeah.
So it takes a little time to condition your hair. After you shampoo your hair, then you want to put conditioner on it.
Yeah,
And that takes some time just to let it sit and soak and
wash, wash, rinse, and go.
Yeah.
So you guys are faster.
This is a new question. It's actually part of my round two questions, but I have to ask it here. Do you guys wash your legs on every shower? Yeah. Must be the one call now.
Yeah.
Man, you're really far down on that list.
I am.
He used to be ahead of me.
Yeah, I usually am ahead of her.
Man, I'm at the top, huh?
I guess today anyway.
Yeah. I was actually having this conversation with Goldie. I was like, I send it to voicemail just about every time because then I can go back and listen to it.
Right.
At my own
And that's leisure. What I do too.
Yep. But do you wash your legs every time you shower?
Uh-huh.
Typically. It depends on if my skin has been subjected to a lot of chlorine.
Okay.
Then my skin dries out. Hmm. So I might just let the water rinse over it.
There's a section of people in the world that they don't wash knee down.
Upper body.
I wash my feet every time because there gets some bacterial build up in there, especially.
There's people that are like once a week knee down. And that's it. And I'm like, huh, that's interesting. And their thought process is the water rolls down, so you don't have to. And I go, man.
Well, and drying effect, the legs can get pretty dried out.
Well, that makes sense.
Well, and I wear shorts, so I'm like, I'm washing them every time.
You wash your upper body really well, and everything just falls down.
Yeah, but there's no, you got to scrub it. Do you all each lock the door when you go to the bathroom at home?
No.
Not with just the two of us anymore.
Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah. That's
fair.
We
used to with
back
the children.
In the day.
Yeah. Sometimes.
Yeah. We don't either.
We had a rule, though.
Separate if the doors, bathroom.
Yeah.
The kids if the doors
have,
closed.
The kids have no shame. They come in.
Knock.
Yeah. I wish, I should figure out how to teach that to my children because they are just sling it open.
Oh,
Dad.
Yeah.
Like, go away. No. Child, I'm busy. Stop it. It's right here, too. It looks like this. They go away.
You could be standing right there and they stub your toe or something.
Oh, they just sling it. I got my little stopper, but it only does so much.
Yeah,
do you guys
training?
Have you guys ever shared supplies? And I'm just talking deodorant, toothbrush, anything that have you shared deodorant?
Yeah.
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 Without him knowing.
There you go.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I need some, and mine's somewhere else. Or
you're missing a chapstick, so you asked for mine.
Right.
Chapstick.
So you're usually borrowing his.
No, it goes both ways. Okay. Some.
How many days of the year are you putting on women's deodorant, Michael?
None, as far as I know. Never. I don't use not her type of brand of deodorant.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
Have you ever, this is also a round two question, but since we're on it, have you ever tried to eat deodorant?
Gross. No.
No.
Okay.
Eat toothpaste before I eat deodorant.
Yeah, I mean, you toothpaste, can swallow toothpaste. Is edible.
Yeah.
The fluoride thing is kind of a lie because there's fluoride in our water. So, like, when they say, you can't eat it because it's toxic.
If you swallow it, it's okay.
You're fine.
A little bit here and there. Although we've had that discussion that there's some research out there that fluoride crosses the blood-brain barrier and can do damage to the brain.
Yeah.
That's another podcast.
That's another podcast. Yeah. There you go.
I mean, yeah, it's part of it. Now, this is one where, hey, did you, before you were married, do you remember ever farting in front of one another? Or maybe, or do you now? Like, maybe you don't now, because I know people now that they're like, absolutely not. That's my thing.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
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 Just say excuse me.
Yeah.
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 I don't before we were married, I don't remember, but I'm sure it happened.
Possibly.
Yeah. I feel like it happens. And, you know, I'm waiting for the rom-com movie where instead of the first kiss, it's that. That's what I want. Because I think it's better.
More authentic?
Yeah.
Or you can be real with each other?
Yeah, there's something there. Do you guys have any diaper stories from your having children in diapers days? I
do have one.
Perfect.
You would have.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, she changed a lot of diapers.
I did.
Fair enough.
We even used cloth diapers because it was cheaper.
Yeah.
So Jeannie Mowry set us up with borax and a diaper pail.
That is an adventure.
Disposable or easier.
I had a clothesline.
I mean, it's just, so you know.
I could hang them out on the clothesline and they could be sanitized by the sun's rays. So we worked hard.
Yeah. Saved a bunch of money. But we did. There's something about...
It's a little labor-intensive.
And they do have diaper services that...
But then you're not saving
your money.
Those are
expensive. Expensive.
Then you might as well just go buy
them. Yeah, no, we washed and dried our own. She washed and dried our own.
We talked about it, and then I was like, no.
Yeah.
I chickened out fast.
One of the worst times, and I can't remember if David was in a cloth diaper or disposable, but probably cloth because the plastic pants and the diaper don't hold everything in as well. That's what covers your cloth diaper.
Okay.
Yeah, then you have, it's not, and you have the cloth diaper, then you have a,
it's just like holding it all in.
Yeah. So you have a two thing.
And David was a toddler and he was on antibiotics for an infection.
Yeah.
Well, that gives diarrhea oftentimes.
Yep.
And so it just went out everywhere, all over the carpet. What a mess to clean up. And I was the only adult home, so at that time.
You still are sometimes. No.
Sure.
He started laughing before I said it. That's like...
Well, in these stories, I don't remember because I wasn't home.
Yeah.
And even if she told me, I forget. That was a long time ago.
Well, and I think he had eaten some Fruit Loops or something like that that's got the heavy food dyes in it. And so it was a colored mess as well.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. I just remember the one story you told me. We were at the rental.
Yeah.
We were at the duplex still. And so I was at work again. But you're telling me David's like learning to walk and he's down the hallway, you know, putting your hands. Oh, that hurts. Okay.
Need to practice.
He re-injured
that stretch.
Himself.
No, and he's walking with his hands, supporting his hands on the wall, right? Well, he comes across the door. The door's not closed, and it pushes open, then he tumbles over.
Oh, I don't remember that.
And I just laughed when you told me this story. Because basically the wall, which was a door, gave way because it wasn't closed all the way. You just tell me he fell over.
So not technically a diaper and bathroom just, story, but a memory.
No, I just laughed
fine.
About it.
That's fine. Well, that's all the questions I have. Kimberly, do you have any bathroom stories that you want to share? Can be about yourself, can be about Michael against his will. You can subject your children to it. I'm fine with that, and I'm sure they would be too. I'll send that.
I think that was the main one with David, but when I was growing up.
Yeah.
Using the outhouse, even my dad would succumb to sitting there for long periods of time, and it's cold, but your legs fall asleep.
Oh,
so then when you pull up your pants and try to walk back to the house, you're walking on pins and needles, or you're walking funny legged.
Falling
because
out of this outhouse. Whoa. Yeah. I mean, I imagine the outhouse toilet seats are not as comfy as...
Well, it can't be. It can be a standard seat, but it's just cold. I've done that in our bathroom too. Just sitting there too long in one position and cutting off the blood flow, so you have to reposition.
Oh no, I understand that fully. It happens to me every single time I record.
There you go.
Yep.
There you go.
I understand
the toilet
fully.
For an hour.
Stand up a little. Lift those.
Yeah. This is exactly where signs. I'm at every time too. Like. Nothing is different except for those mics and you guys here. It's a real treasure. Well, cool.
I don't know if that's good for your legs to cut off circulation for that long.
I have one since the last time we recorded.
Oh, boy.
So I got, I'll always remember April 9th, Easter Sunday, this past April 9th. Yeah. I got sick and I got the literal flu.
Oh.
And I spent the day at home. Everybody was out at Easter dinner.
Correct.
And I spent the day at home. Right after church, I just got sick.
Oh,
and I went home and I was.
Right.
And then I had to take Monday off because I was still vomiting.
He shouldn't have been at church. How many people did he infect?
I remember you telling
I thought if the attendance is down the following Sunday, you can blame me. But no, it was Monday, the day after Easter. And this has never happened before, but you hear about it. I think I vomited first. And then right after, you go to the toilet and you vomit. Right after that, I did a 180 and I just let loose in the toilet. So I vomited. 2 seconds later, I pooped. And it was diarrhea.
Right here,
but it was like... You know, and you hear about stories like that, and that's never happened. That's the first time. One, two, 3 seconds later, you turn around, and the other.
Yeah.
Boom, boom.
You.
It's like,
we
wow.
Always have, we have these on deck ever since Anna was pregnant.
Those are from the school.
No, they're from Amazon. We bought a bulk pack of them, because ever since Anna was pregnant, she had the worst morning sickness, and she was sick of either just hugging a bowl or hugging the... trash, and so we bought just a bunch of them, and we've had them since. And then you can go two at the same time, you know.
Looks like an airplane vomit bag.
Yeah, it's they're the ones that they have in the hospital.
Yeah,
and we used to when
school
we
district uses them
when we were broker. We would just steal them from the hospital every time we went. We'd get in the cupboard and grab a pile and stuff them in Anna's purse and
confessions.
We paid for it indirectly, but
yes, true.
You walk in and breathe air in a hospital, you paid for everything in there. Well, that's fun, Michael. I'm sorry that you had the flu.
That was the first time in, decades that I got that sick.
But everything made it in the bowl.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Yep.
I guess
good
so.
Job.
I wasn't there to witness.
Wow.
Yeah.
You I've didn't heard clean of, up big messes.
I've heard of people when they get to that point, they just lay in the shower, like in the tub and...
Oh,
turn the water on.
Let it all go down
the
drain.
That's you're in a bad state at that point. Like you need.
Okay, so I do have a story on him. Hopefully he won't mind. My mom paid for a trip for us to go deep water fishing off the coast of Washington. We did not get our motion sickness medicine in us soon enough.
Or not at all.
Well, we had taken some, but it was not doing the trick. And that diesel smoke was horrible.
Yeah, this boat's going
And the waves, the movement of the water was pretty bad early that morning, too. And I did get to fish some.
You recovered.
I would vomit, and then I would be okay to fish some more. Michael was on the bottom of the boat. The entire
must have been a 2 or 3 hour trip.
Oh,
I was vomiting.
He had to wet his pants on the bottom of the boat.
I did no fish. I just sat down on the deck and just vomited for 2 or 3 hours.
You were laying on the deck, honey, part of the time.
Whoa.
Yeah. The entire time.
He was miserable.
I mean, even if I wouldn't have been out of commission, if I throw up, I'm done. Like,
I didn't know I had that much in me to vomit. I mean, at that point, you're just vomiting water or whatever.
Yeah, dry heaves.
Yeah.
That sounds
awful. I was able to drink.
It was like, wow.
7-Up or
Sprite. So no cruises for you then?
Well, bigger boats are fine.
I mean, maybe. You don't know.
Maybe. He doesn't know. He's never been on one.
Yeah, I've never. Yeah.
Yeah. We've talked about trying a cruise.
I've never.
Should
do more. I don't know. I mean,
I would love to hear about Michael on a cruise.
A repositioning cruise.
You know, cheaper. Once you pay for it, all the food there, you just eat it. You don't pay for the food. You just go eat.
Yep.
And you don't have to stop.
Have you ever been on a cruise, Hunter?
I haven't. I think they're dumb.
Okay.
But that's for me. Anna wants to go on one. And I'm like, you're on a boat.
Without the kids, though.
Well, she's looked at that, too. Like, the Disney cruises. And I'm like,
oh, well, if you're going to do that, take the kids.
Yeah, I don't know. It's to me, I'm like, I need something to do on the boat other than regular hotel activities. Like,
there's hundreds of activities.
Well, a water slide. I'm like, okay.
There's just, you can, I mean, there's, what? Literally, have you seen these cruise ships?
Yeah, but it's a lot of buffets and a lot of
games, I suppose, or some entertainment.
I feel like you're camping, but you're on a boat in a hotel. Because it's like, well, I guess we
talk to Dean. Dean and...
Yeah.
He went on a...
Dean's different, though. Like,
on a multi-month
cruise. He's content with things that I don't understand. Do you know what I'm saying? Like,
he's a lot older.
Mm-hmm. I love Dean.
He might or may not listen to this podcast.
I doubt it. From what I can tell, he doesn't.
Probably not.
The scope is very interesting. There's no rhyme or reason.
Talk to anyone who's been on a cruise.
Yeah. My cousins go all the time. And
yeah. My aunt and uncle went on one, but they actually were on the one cruise where the boat turned a little bit too sharp and there was rough water, and the cruise ship tipped over.
Oh, yeah, that would do
they
it for me.
They were refunded or given another trip.
Just hearing the story would put me out of it. I'm like, yeah, I don't think I'm ever...
sounded a little...
I'm never going to look at a boat again.
Treacherous.
Yeah. Huh.
Anyway, how did we get on this topic?
Well...
You threw up on the bottom of a fishing boat.
Oh, yeah, that's right. The story.
Yeah, he's yakking.
That was my worst.
That was pretty bad. But I have asked him, if we got medicine in us a couple days ahead of time, continually, would he attempt it again? He said, yes, he'd be willing to go deep sea fishing again.
That would be fun. Deep sea fishing would be fun.
I got to catch all of his.
I'd probably need
and
a prescription, though. Yeah.
You might.
Huh. Yeah, do you ride fair rides?
No.
You should try one just to see what the effect is. Because my dad.
Oh, I've done. Yeah.
My dad goes every shade of green. It's hilarious.
I've done. And I did Disneyland for a couple times in the 70s. But I've been to the fair and rode some rides.
As a kid. You did the Disneyland.
Yeah. Have you been to Disney as an adult?
No.
Oh, Michael.
No, as a kid, I did not get sick on fair rides or Disneyland rides and stuff like that. And I went on a boat as a kid, and I did not get sick.
Yeah. You know, I used to be able to ride anything, and then Silas put me on the Tilt-A-Whirl at the Montana State Fair last year. And I rode it once, and he said, again, and I said, here's the deal, bud. If I do that ride again, I am done for the day. Because I was just spinny.
Yeah. I don't. Those rides now, I don't do them.
Like,
I don't do well with them either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They would make me sick.
I don't get it. Why is it?
What's the one that's like, it's a big circle, like a centrifuge almost.
The gravitron.
And you're strapped in against the wall.
Yeah.
And it goes around and around.
That would make
me sick. And then it goes up, and so somebody could vomit down on top of you.
It's just slinging.
I've
ridden
rides.
That a couple times, and it's a little...
Those rides, no.
I don't like fair rides, because they take them up and put them down every week.
Yeah.
That's like, this can't be safe. Like, these bolts can't be as tight as they should be.
It's not cemented to the ground.
Yeah.
There have been some serious accidents.
Yeah. Well, Kimberly, do you have any bathroom wisdom to leave people with?
Well, I think the wiping one's a good one.
Yeah.
You know?
Spit in your toilet paper.
Save some trees.
Yeah,
Michael. I mean, there are rotten trees out there.
Use the least amount.
Michael. Yeah.
And don't worry if you get a little bit on your hands. It will wash.
Right.
just like diapers wash and
yeah.
bloody bodies wash and, you know.
There you Help. Go. Bloody. Okay.
well.
Michael, do you have any updated bathroom wisdom?
You can edit that.
Oh, no way. That's the stuff right there.
You know.
It's all part of a bathroom.
No.
Yes. Just
public bathrooms are so gross. The people that use them before you. It's like, I'm neat.
They can be disgusting.
You know, I'm typically the same way I use my own bathroom as how I use a public bathroom. And
right.
you're neat about it.
Yeah.
And there's like, why are there paper towels all over the floor? And
right.
What? It's you dumb. Know,
well, like, even being
Are you that messy when you're at home?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's they what are. We've asked. Even being church custodians, if there's stuff left behind in the toilet and it appears that
Michael,
they didn't even attempt to flush.
Every
what's
week.
Going flush at on? Home?
Every week, Michael brings up to me either the young adults, the youth, or some elderly person in the bathroom who hasn't flushed.
Do you not flush at home is like what I want to ask?
They probably don't.
There's, or did they just get distracted by somebody or something else?
And who unplugs your toilet at home when you...
They get distracted
by
their phones.
You plug it at the church, I unplug it for you. Yeah. You plug it at home, who unplugged your toilet at home?
Probably their mommy. Like, I'm not know. Even goofing.
Maybe they call their adult son or daughter over something.
Oh, the
know.
Elderly, yeah.
Elderly yeah, the elderly.
Person, maybe.
Probably have a caregiver. I don't know. Yeah. Like, maybe they don't... Maybe they save it for the church. Well, I'm gonna do the outro. It's always I told Michael I've said it before. It's kind of like staring at a dog pooping in the backyard, but I have to do it every time. But thank you guys for being here.
You are welcome.
In my home bathroom, you've arrived. You're the first in here for this.
It says so. Privycast, a podcast about bathrooms.
Anna had that made
right behind your toilet.
Those are cool.
It's official, I guess, something.
You can. Yeah, those are metal, and they cut them out. Yeah.
Yeah.
Those
this is cool. your hub.
This is my recording studio. This is literally what I do every time I record. I have had people send me a message saying, no, you don't. I'm like, partner, yes. Trust me, ask my wife. She'll explain it. She is like, I don't know. He just, yeah.
Well, I don't know if you have a little bit more time. I was going to say.
Oh, go for it.
My family did a lot of camping and backpacking.
Oh, yes.
So the outdoors, literally, the wilds is your bathroom
That's
sometimes.
Right.
And make sure you know what plants are safe in case you don't have toilet paper with you.
Yeah.
So we've used moss or ferns or large leaves.
Mm-hmm. I had a buddy on the show who was, he does trail crews in Arizona. And he told me, I believe he told me he uses pine cones, but he uses the like young.
So that they don't have the spines on them.
But I'm sitting here going, listen, there's a lot else out there. There's so much more.
A pine cone might do a great job.
My sock is better than that. Like
I've
used my sock before I went with that. They used to use corn cobs.
And then you just buried your sock or you burned it in the fire?
Pack it out. Put it in your pocket. No.
There you go. A good trash bag. Pack it in,
turn it inside out. Yeah.
There you go.
No, they used to use corn cobs.
Yes,
they would
did.
Eat the corn, and then they would save the spent cobs and just back there.
That's good fire starter, that's too.
In wild to me. That's a different level.
Yeah. Well, if you're a true conservationist, you might not be carrying toilet paper out there with
I'm
you.
Not. I'm not. Michael.
We always carried some toilet paper.
What's your favorite tea?
Brand. What's your preferred brand?
Yeah, toilet
well,
paper.
Well, I actually like Kirkland. Costco's fine. But I do like Charmin. With Charmin,
bears.
I only have to use two squares most of the time.
The beautiful bears. It's good stuff. Red bag or blue bag, do you know, Charmin?
Oh, I'm not sure. Either one probably will do me.
The red bag's a little thicker.
Okay. They do. It's like ultra.
Yeah. But the blue bag's pretty traditional.
So I know some who maybe suffer from, I'll say, hemorrhoids. a softer toilet paper helps. It's more gentle.
We got a bidet. Mm-hmm. Feel free to partake here in a little while if you want, Michael. I will say the pressure is more than anybody thinks it needs to be.
But that can help some
I've
people
heard that
with
helps
those
it.
Problems.
That's not why yes. we got it, but I have heard that will help that. Anyway.
I think bidets should make a huge comeback.
They're great.
You're not using toilet paper then like you
You
would
still
before.
Use a little bit, but yeah, it's not...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you could have a fabric... towel and throw it in a laundry basket or a diaper pail.
Michael's
let
face.
It soak and wash it.
Michael's
and
face.
That might be eco
Just
groovy.
Use Michael's shower towel. He'll never know. He'll never know.
Probably
That's
not.
What the towel behind your head's for. No, I'm just kidding.
So with our children, I actually did purchase a towel, cut it up into many small pieces, used my sewing machine to zigzag the edges and use those as cleaning cloths or wipes for their dirty bottoms because that also saved money.
Might as well. But
when you helped them wipe before they did on their
no,
own?
No, this was when I was cleaning up dirty diapers.
Yeah.
To clean their bottoms, I just
used...
the
cloth diapers out anyway, so...
The cloth diapers and those towel wipes went into the diaper pail.
Yeah.
So for anybody listening that might want to save on money...
Old t-shirts...
Absolutely.
Gets it done too. That's all those school t-shirts
Very
they give
well.
Us. It's their future.
Yeah.
No, please give me more of them. Well, thank you guys for being here.
You're welcome. Sure.
And thank you all for listening. This has been another episode of Privy. I'm not going to do all the doodly-doos. You can figure those out. But now... Oh, yeah.
Spit?
Yeah, spit on your toilet
spit
paper.
And use little as possible.
Yeah, spit on your toilet paper. Try it out.
Fold your toilet paper over one or two times.
Yeah, and spit on it.
And spit on it again.
This has been another episode of Privy. Thanks for listening. And now, as always, don't forget to flush.
That's how I do it every single time. Just jam the thing back there and let it ride.